More gaming performance, cooler temperatures, and less fan noise are three things that all laptop gamers want. And this small water cooler solves all of these problems. Let's test it out by comparing laptops on air and water cooling. We've tested both air and water cooling on the same laptops, the Neo 15 from XMG in Europe, also known as the Electronics Mech 15 G3 in the US. The only difference between these two laptops is that one has an RTX 3070 Ti, while the other has an RTX 3080 Ti. Both were tested because I wanted to see if the liquid cooler could help out the higher specs more, because in theory it should be throttling more. Both of these laptops also allow us to set the maximum possible GPU power limit instead of relying on dynamic boost. This means that the 3070 Ti should always be running at 150 watts, while the 3080 Ti should always be running at 175 watts. However, this wasn't actually possible on air cooling due to thermal throttling. This is where the water cooler comes in. It's just as awesome as up to $1,000 Australian off Intel 11th gen Gigabyte laptops. Gigabyte has sponsored this part of the video, so I can tell you about some serious sales they've got going right now. If you're a gamer, then you're going to want to check out their Aorus lineup. With Intel's 11th gen Core i7 processors and Nvidia's RTX 30 series graphics, you'll be covered for all your gaming needs. Otherwise, the Aero series is perfect for content creators. So what are you waiting for? Check out these deals with the sponsored link in the video description. Alright, back to the liquid cooler. This is known as the XMG Oasis, or Liquid Propulsion Package at Electronics. The way it works is quite simple. Connect it to the back of the laptop and turn it on. Water flows through this pipe, which is soldered to the regular heat pipes, so you can use either air or water cooling on the same laptop. Though right now, I think XMG only supports the Neo 15 with the Oasis cooler, but in theory they'll be able to expand to more models in future. Right now, XMG offers the liquid cooler for 200 euro, but current prices are linked below. Honestly, this isn't bad at all when you consider that the Neo 15 with 3070 Ti is 2484 euro, so 8% more money if you include the cooler, or just 6% more money if included with the higher spec 3080 Ti model. These are the temperatures on both laptops while under combined CPU and GPU stress test to represent a worst case scenario. With air cooling, both laptops were hitting thermal throttle limits at 90 degrees Celsius on the CPU, as shown by the blue bars, and 87 on the GPU in the green bars. I've tested the water cooler two different ways, with the laptop's fans set to automatic for a quieter result, or with the laptop fans maxed out. We'll have a listen to the difference in a moment. With the fans maxed out on the 3070 Ti machine, we're able to lower the CPU temperature by 20 degrees Celsius and the GPU by 25. Pretty crazy improvements with the liquid cooler. The 3080 Ti had a similar temperature difference between air and water cooling, though the processor only dipped back 10 degrees Celsius. These are the clock speeds being hit during these same tests. I've split the CPU's P and E cores up as they reach different speeds. The air cooling results were like 500 to 600 MHz slower on the CPU due to the thermal throttling that was happening, while the GPUs were 200 to 300 MHz lower. So not only is the water cooling significantly lowering temperatures, it's giving us much better performance too. It's worth noting that the 8 E cores in the 3080 Ti laptop were reaching 300 MHz higher speeds, despite both laptops having the same i7-12700H processor. We can see why when we look at the reported TDP being reached. With the liquid coolers attached, we're hitting basically the full GPU power limit as expected. But the CPU in the 3080 laptop was going higher. Why though? The total system power draw measured at the wall offers a hint. Of course, we're using more power with the liquid cooler attached, as that's an extra piece of hardware we need to run. But the majority of the extra power is because the laptops aren't thermal throttling anymore, so they're able to pull down more power and perform better. The 3080 Ti laptop came with a 330 watt power brick, while the 3070 Ti laptop came with a slightly smaller 280 watt power brick. Don't panic though, although this gave us a little difference in the stress tests, it doesn't actually do anything when comparing real games. Gaming performance on the 3080 Ti laptop was the same in 6 different titles with either the 280 or 330 watt brick attached. So the extra power only seems useful if you fully max out both the CPU and GPU together, something most games don't really do. Now let's hear what the differences in fan noise actually are. Both sound about the same with the liquid cooler attached, but the laptop fan still manually maxed out. It was slightly louder with the liquid cooler. But you absolutely don't have to run the laptop with its fans maxed out. It's possible to run quieter with the liquid cooler by letting the laptop fans automatically adjust. Sure, the temperatures were a bit warmer this way, but honestly, given we're still hitting max performance while having a much quieter system compared to almost all other gaming laptops, I think it's very impressive. Alright, so now that we've actually got an idea of what the liquid cooler is capable of, let's see what the performance differences are in games between air and water cooling on both of these laptops. Let's start out with God of War. I've got the 1080p results down the bottom and the 1440p results above, with the air cooled results below the water cooled results. At the lower 1080p resolution, the liquid cooling was able to give us a 13% higher average frame rate, while the liquid cooler gets the 3080 Ti above 100fps at 1440p, a slightly larger 14% boost just by connecting the cooler. Dying Light 2 had a 10 to 11% performance boost with a liquid cooler at either resolution. I mean, high settings at 1440p on air being over 60fps isn't bad at all, but we can unlock full performance with better cooling. Performance drops back with ray tracing enabled, even with DLSS set to balanced mode. Although we can use DLSS to boost performance, it can only do so much when our system is thermal throttling on air, which is where the liquid cooler steps in to save the day. Cyberpunk 2077 saw the biggest performance difference between air and liquid cooling out of all 14 games tested. At 1080p, we're almost hitting a 19% higher average frame rate. Even the 1% lows with liquid cooling were close to the average FPS that was possible on the throttling air setup. This game was also tested with the higher ultra ray tracing preset, but with DLSS set to balanced mode, the frame rates don't drop back a whole lot, though the difference between air and liquid cooling was pretty similar. Microsoft Flight Simulator, on the other hand, had the largest performance difference at the higher 1440p resolution out of the games tested, hitting 15% higher average FPS with a liquid cooler. The gap was smaller as far as average frame rate is concerned at the lower 1080p resolution, but the 1% low gains were still 12% on liquid. It's not all epic gains though. Take Far Cry 6 for instance. We're looking at a 3fps difference or so at the higher 1440p resolution, probably not something you're likely to actually notice. The differences at 1080p were a little larger though, with an extra 8fps. But again, percentage-wise, the 1% low gains were larger. This changes a bit with FSR enabled. The gap at 1440p was now larger with this setting enabled. It's not a super amazing gain, but hey, an 8% boost for 6% more money, not to mention a quieter system and cooler temps, is sounding very reasonable. Assassin's Creed Valhalla also had below average differences out of the games tested. Honestly, even at 1440p very high settings with these frame rates on air, you're going to be playing this game very well no problem, which you'd expect from a 12th gen i7 and 3080 Ti even with some throttling. Though of course the liquid cooler removes this and boosts performance by 6% at 1440p. Red Dead Redemption 2 had an above average performance gain on water cooling, almost a 10fps boost at the higher 1440p resolution, which equates to an 11% performance boost. Control was tested with and without ray tracing and DLSS. With neither of these, we're looking at a 9% higher average FPS at 1440p on water cooling. There's still a 9% improvement with ray tracing enabled. It just doesn't look like as much of a change because the frame rates are lower. DLSS can be used to significantly boost performance. And again, we're still seeing about a 9% boost with the liquid cooler connected at 1440p. So presumably, it's removing the same level of throttling regardless of our settings. We'll just blast through the last 6 games so that we can get into the good stuff. It's important to test as many games as possible to get a better rounded average, but we don't need to talk through all of these. Feel free to pause the video if you want a closer look at these results. On average, out of all 14 games, we're looking at a 9% higher average frame rate at the lower 1080p resolution with the NVIDIA RTX 3080 Ti. Worst case, there's just a 4% gain with the games down the bottom like Assassin's Creed, while others like Cyberpunk right up the top were close to reaching a 19% higher average frame rate. A great result given the liquid cooler only adds 6% to the cost. The difference was only slightly larger at the higher 1440p resolution. On average, liquid cooling was reaching 10% higher average FPS in these 14 games. I didn't include all the individual 3070 Ti game graphs as it would have dragged the video out forever, but you can check them out for free on my Patreon page with the link in the description. But even if you don't want to check them out, we'll still go through the averages here. The results were a bit lower in the same selection of games with the RTX 3070 Ti laptop at 1080p. I suspect that the difference in games between air and liquid cooling on the 3080 Ti laptop is bigger than the 3070 ATI laptop as it throttles back harder on air. Anyway, an 8% boost to average FPS for 8% more money with the liquid cool-up sounds fair, not to mention less fan noise and lower temperatures. The differences weren't much different at 1440p on the 3070 Ti. We're still looking at around an 8% higher average frame rate with the liquid cooler connected. So if you're getting one of these laptops that can actually support the liquid cooler, I can definitely recommend it if you want better performance, lower temperatures, or less fan noise. There is a bit more complexity attaching the liquid cooler compared to just relying on air cooling, but I think after some practice, it's pretty straightforward. Honestly, disconnecting the cooler wasn't as hard as I thought it would be, and I'm someone that's got zero water cooling experience. I've drained these laptops more than 10 times now during testing, and with the included drainage adapter, it's pretty hard to leak liquid on the laptop. Now, although we primarily focused on the RTX 3080 Ti in this video, I don't really think it's worth buying compared to the 3070 Ti. Check out this video next to see all of the differences between them and why you should probably just save your money and stick with the 3070 Ti. And of course, if you're new to the channel, thanks for watching, and get subscribed for future gaming laptop content like this.